Welcome back. Well, in business tonight, potential homeowners may soon have cooler options when looking to build or buy a house. Pecanco Limited plans to introduce more energy-efficient homes to the local market. The company's operations manager, Joshua Reed, says it's part of their commitment towards investing in eco-friendly systems and products.
We have some new products which we are in the process of developing, which is ultimately going to lead to more efficient buildings, cooler houses, and you know, it is going to be more energy efficient, because once you develop a product that allows for a cooler building or a cooler house, you know, that minimizes the need for electricity to run fans and air conditions and different things like that. And for larger buildings, obviously looking at the design of the building, you know, there's the lighting aspect of the building, getting as much light inside the building from the design, and how it is structured also from an efficiency standpoint. So we are looking at developing some products, and we do have some actually under testing right now.
According to Mr. Reed, eco-friendly technology is increasingly becoming a key part of the design and functionality of new homes.
I think that right now there's enough information available to show the results and benefits that you can gain from the systems. I agree that, you know, a price increase in the materials required to do the system will have an effect on it, but I'm certain that it will still prove to be effective. And I would recommend, if anyone is considering to do it, that they take the time to ask the questions to the people who maybe have done it already, and also get some feedback from different businesses who can provide you with the system.
Despite a poor fourth quarter performance due largely to the impact of hurricanes in the region, Goddard Enterprises Limited has recorded a successful year. According to the group's consolidated financial highlights for the year ended September 30th, the group saw growth in most of its major sectors. This was achieved even though revenues declined by 2.5% due to tax challenges in the manufacturing and services division, and the sale of two food businesses in 2016 and the rum business this year. Profit from operations net was $63.7 million, representing an increase of 2.1% above the $62.4 million achieved last year. Meanwhile, Chairman Charles Herbert and Managing Director Anthony Ali say the outlook for the group is positive, despite uncertainty in some markets where the group operates. Time now to take a look at how stocks traded on selected exchanges across the region. Up first is Jamaica, where Carreras Limited was the volume leader with 783,538 units, and they were followed by NCB Financial Group Limited and Panjam Investment Limited. In Trinidad, Sagicor Financial Corporation Limited was the volume leader with 275,873 shares changing hands for a value of $2,206,084, and they were followed by Grace Kennedy Limited and Guardian Holdings Limited. Right here in Barbados, Sagicor Financial Corporation Limited was the volume leader, trading 23,005 shares at $2.10 each, and they were followed by Fortress Caribbean Property Fund, Value Fund.